Welcome to Let Us Learn YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about the DC generator module 4 part 3. In this session we are going to discuss about the types of DC generator and application of a DC motor. How the DC generators classified? As already we discussed in the previous videos, that the generator having two main windings are there. One is called as a field winding, another one is called as a armature winding. Field winding is the stationary and the armature winding is the rotating winding. See, in this, according to the different connection, field winding and the armature winding, how it is connected. According to the connection, how the DC generator is classified. That we will see in detail in the upcoming slides. And we will discuss about the application of a DC motor. Where and all the DC motor is used in day-to-day life. It may be a domestic or it may be industry or some other research, etc., etc. It will be there. So this session, that is DC generator part 3, we will start with this two topic, that is a types of DC generators and then application of a DC motor. So this diagram, it shows the cross section view of the DC generator. Here the main two parts are, one is called as a field winding, another one is called as a armature winding. Field winding is a stationary winding and then armature winding is a rotating winding. So in this F1 and F2, it shows the symbolic representation of your field winding. So here F1 and F2 is given. So this is called as a field winding, which is wounded on the pole course. So this is called a field winding. If you give supply or if as a motor, will supply will be given to this field winding. A generator will feed the supply from this winding. And this A1 and A2 are the armature winding. This is the symbolic representation of armature winding. So this, it shows the armature winding. This, it shows the carbon brushes. Here also we are having two carbon brushes are there. Now we are going to discuss what are the types of DC generator and then how it is classified. Now, types of DC generator. In this, a DC generator is classified as a separately excited and self-excited DC generator. What is called separately excited? As already we discussed, we are having two windings. One is called as the field winding, another one is called as the armature winding. Both the windings are separately each other. So the external source will be given for this winding, and then self-excited. Self-excited means the winding will be inside there. It will be like a shunt ohm. Shunt means the armature and then field winding, both are connected in parallel, or otherwise we can say as across. Series wound. Series wound mean armature winding and then field winding, both are connected in series. Compound. Compound is a combination of shunt wound and then series wound. Further, the compound wound DC generator is classified as a short shunt and long shunt. Now we are going to see these different types of DC generator in detail. In types of DC generator, first we are going to discuss about the separately excited DC generator. The two winding, field winding and then armature winding, should be separate each other. And then field winding, we have to excite that winding with the help of some external source or any other battery. And then after that, the field winding get excited. Due to this field winding excitation, this armature, it starts to rotate. And then here, the notations are RF. RF is the field winding resistance. IF is the field winding current. IA is the armature current. And then EG is the EMF in the armature. And then here we have to write the RA. RA is the armature resistance. IL is the load current. And then V is the voltage. So according to the name, the separately excited DC generator, the field winding and then armature winding, it should be separate each other. And then for the field winding, we have to give some external source to excite this field winding. Following this, we are going to discuss about the series DC generator. So in series wound DC generator, this field winding and then armature winding, it should be connected in series. Already we know that the any head is connected with other's tail, or other's tail which is connected to other's head. This fashion is called as a series connection. So here also we are having two, that is a series field winding and then armature winding are connected back to back. So this fashion is called as the series form generator and then series connection. Here the armature and then field winding, series field winding are connected back to back, and then the current IA is equal to ISC, that is equal to IL, because all three are connected in series. So in a series circuit the current will remains constant. So here IA is the armature current and then RA is the armature resistance, EG is the EMF, RSE is the series field resistance, ISC is the series field current, IL is the load current, and then V is the voltage. Now shunt field generator. Shunt, meaning of the shunt is that is across, or otherwise you can say is a parallel. So from this name only you can come to know that armature winding and then field winding, both it should be connected in parallel. As already we discussed in the DC circuits, if the head is connected with other's head and tail is connected with other's tail, that fashion is called as the parallel connection or shunt connection. So here armature winding and then shunt field winding, both are connected in parallel. So this connection is called as the shunt field winding. So the current in this armature is IA and then resistance in the armature is RA, EMF which is generated in the armature is EG, ISH is the shunt field current, IRSH is the shunt field resistance, IL is the load current, and V is the voltage. Following that, we are going to discuss about the compound generator. Compound generator means it is a combination of series and then shunt winding will be there. So under the compound generator, we are going to discuss about the short shunt generator and then long shunt generator. In a short shunt generator, the shunt field winding, it should be connected only across the armature. See, can see clearly, this is a shunt field winding because this is connected parallel to the armature winding only. So the shunt field winding, it should be connected only parallel to the armature winding. And then series winding we are having separate. So here this shunt, we are having two field winding. One is called as shunt field winding, other one is called as series field winding. Series field winding is connected series to the load, and then shunt field winding is connected parallel to the armature winding. So EG is the EMF in the armature, RA is the armature resistance, IA is the armature current, ISH is the shunt field current, RSH is the shunt field resistance, ISC is the series field current, and then RSE is the series field resistance, IL is the load current, and then V is the voltage. In this, according to Kirchhoff's current law, incoming is equal to outgoing. So IA is equal to ISH plus ISE. But ISC and then IL both are connected in series. So ISE is equal to IL. This is the current relation for the short shunt generator. We will discuss this upcoming videos. We will discuss this in detail about the voltage and then current relation for the different types of generator in the upcoming videos. So following this, we are going to discuss about the long shunt generator. So in long shunt generator, the shunt field winding should be connected across the series field winding and then armature. So it should cover the, it should connected across the series field winding and then armature winding. So if you hide this, if you are not considering the series field winding, so it will act as a shunt field winding. If you are not considering the shunt field winding, it will act as a series field winding. So this type of winding is called as a long shunt generator. The shunt field winding should be connected across the armature and then series field winding. So here EG is the EMF in the armature, and then RA is the armature resistance, IA is the armature current, and then RSE is the series field current, RSE is the series field resistance, ISE is the series field current, ISH is the shunt field current, RSH is the shunt field resistance, IL is the load current, and V is the voltage. So here IA is the incoming current, IL and then ISH are the outgoing current. So current relation IA is equal to IL plus ISH. So now we have completed the types of generator. Now we are going to see about the application of your DC motor. Now application of a DC motor. In this we are going to discuss the application for the separately excited motor. It is used in trains and diesel electric propulsion of ships, paper machines, steel rolling mills, and then automotive traction. These are the applications for the separately excited DC motor. So in this DC shunt motor. DC shunt motor is a constant speed motor. So it is used in fixed speed applications like lathe mills, pumps, and fans. So this application mostly we need the constant speed of motor. So we are using for lathe, pumps, and then fan. Since it is a constant speed motor, the other name of DC shunt motor is a constant speed motor. So now we are going to discuss about the DC series motor. It is a high speed, high starting torque. The initial torque of the DC motor will be more high. So according to that characteristics, we are going to use this DC series motor in hoist, cranes, high speed tools, electric traction, trolley, elevators, cars, conveyors, air compressors, vacuum cleaner, etc. Because these applications we need the high starting torque, so we are using in this type of applications. Next, following to that, we are going to discuss the application of a DC compound motor. DC compound motor is used in electric welding, rolling mills, domestic lighting. I hope this video is very useful for you. Thank you. Subscribe, support, share, let us learn.